So the third ground that make a contract voidable because the consent is vitiated, or yung tinatawag nating vices of consent, is under 1338 or on cases of fraud. So under 1338, it says that there is fraud when through insidious words or machinations of one of the contracting parties, the other is induced to enter into a contract which without them, he would not have agreed to. So here, ano ba yung definition? Ano bang ibig sabihin ng fraud? Or other call this one as dolo. Ano? Dolo or fraud is, ito nga yung under 1338, the use of words which are, or machinations, insidious words which would have moved the party to enter into a contract, pero if without them hindi sana yon mag-agree yung party, ano. So may dalawa po tayong kinds ng fraud. Ang una ay yung incidental fraud at saka yung pangalawa ay yung causal fraud. Kapag causal fraud siya, ito po pwede, ang causal fraud po nagsasubject siya for the annulment ng contract kapag ito'y present. Tatandaan natin ha, causal fraud would cause the annulment or cancellation ng contract. Pero kapag siya'y incidental fraud naman, ito lang ay nagigiver ay to the party to demand for damages. Ano ba yung causal fraud? Or dolo causante. Ang dolo causante, ito'y committed before or at the time of the perfection of the or celebration of the contract to secure for consent of the other. So ang gamit dito ay insidious words or machinations, ano. And then dito naman sa atin pong ano po yung insidious words, ito yung mga misrepresentation in words or actions done in a fraudulent na way. So let's say for example yung sasabihin mo na yun ay diamond, pero yun ay ano pala, puwet ng baso. So, talaga yung panlilin lang. So, gumagamit ka ng words to misrepresent the true identity of the object. So, incidental fraud naman or dolo causante, yan. Basically, ito po ay committed before. Incidental, ano, committed after, sorry, causante. Incidental fraud are committed after the perfection of the contract. So, tatandaan natin dito, entitled siya for damages ang party who has been injured or have been aggrieved because of the fraud. So, that fraud that does not have such a decisive influence and by itself cannot cause the giving of the consent, but only refers to some particular or accident of the person employing it. Ano? So, entitlement to pay for damages ang po pwede. Ano ba yung requirements po natin para po masasabi na ang fraud would vitiate consent? So, basically, ang fraud ay serious. Tapos, importante din na siya ay sinasadya or deliberate, ano? To deceive or to induce the party, and then the other party has relied on that untrue na statement, so or untrue na actions or misrepresentations, and then in order that it would vitiate consent, dapat yung other party then is not as well at fault, kasi meron po tayong konsepto ng pari delicto, yun yung tipong both parties is in fault. So, kapag ganun, hindi po pwede yun na so one would go to court and then have a recourse or remedy. Hindi po pwede kasi ang may kasabihin nga tayo na he who comes to court should come with a clean hand. So, hindi yun po pwede. By the way, dolo causante is under this provision ha, 1338. Tapos, ang insidente ay under the provisions of 1334. So, but if you have to distinguish these two types of fraud, ang causante ay serious siya in character as being stipulated under 1338 that would render the contract voidable and vitiate consent. Tapos, ang insidente, hindi siya serious. Tapos, ang causante, well, it is the ones that induces the party to whom it is employed to enter into the contract. So, basically, an incidental fraud ay hindi siya cannot itself cause the giving of the consent. Ano? So, in causante as well, the effect of which is to render the contract voidable. Whereas, sa incidente, it would render the party who employed such fraudulent act to be liable for damages. So, let's have an example. Pagpapalagay baga, I have agreed to deliver to you 100 sacks of rice. Ano? Denurado rice. Tapos, ang ginawa ko naman ay ang deliver ko sa iyo ay denurado, oo, pero nakalagay siya sa denurado lang na sako, pero ang laman ay NFA. Pupwede ba na mag-bring ako ng action into court to annul or to cancel the contract on the ground of fraud? Well, pupwede ba na ipapa-annul ko nga ang contract? Well, basically, no in that case. Bakit? Kasi yung fraud ay committed after the contract was already perfected. So, this is a dolo incidente or incidental fraud. So, I am entitled to ask for, or you are entitled, nakalimutan ko na kung sinong injured sa atin. So, you are entitled to ask for damages. Let's have 1339. Well, under 1339, ha, it's not yet 1342 dumiretso dito. Well, under 1339 is being stipulated that failure to disclose facts when there is a duty to reveal them as when the parties are bound by a confidential relations constitutes fraud. So, ang ibig sabihin lang nito is that the person, kapag siya ay bound or under an obligation to disclose fair facts, must state all the facts. Otherwise, masasabi natin na guilty siya of fraud or concealment. So, ang example nito ay yung sa insurance. Very common to sa insurance. Insurance kasi, importante na i-declare mo lahat ng mga illnesses mo, o di kaya man ay may medical conditions ka or nakaka-experience ka ng surgeries or any treatment, dapat yun ay i-declare mo or i-disclose mo. Kapag po ay hindi mo siya i-declare, nakaka-apekto kasi yun sa pag-assess ng iyong babayaran sa insurance at the same time sa coverage. Ano? So, importante lang. So, kapag po hindi mo dineclare, ay ang mayayari po ay you would be guilty of you would be guilty of fraud, ano, or concealment. So, pagpapalagay din. Tayo ay magpa-partner sa sa pagbibenta ng real estate. Ngayon, ako, we're in a partnership, real estate ang ating business. So ngayon ako, I heard of a possible na purchaser ng isang lupa belonging to the company, ano. But I did not tell you about it. Instead, ako, I persuade that person who wanted to buy to not tell you and not to share it with the partnership. So, after po nagkaroon ng selling transaction, well, I have got a big profit. Well, you don't know naman. So, in that case, could I be held liable to you as my partner for fraud or for deceit, ano, for not telling you? Well, basically, it's oo, ano. There is a duty on the part of every partner, lalo na to disclose the facts because we are in a partnership. So, we have a mutual agency, ano, and anything that I would go into, especially sir, in relation to our business, basically would bind as well the partnership. So, the personality of one partner with me is the personality na din ng the other partner. So, yung akin pong hindi pagko-confide sa iyo bilang aking partner would render me liable of all the profits and then plus pa the damages. Kasi, and I should have to pay it to you. Ano, because of that fraud or deceit. 1340, paano naman daw kapag yung mga exaggerations in trade, when the other party have an opportunity to know the facts, ano yung treatment natin doon? Would it be considered as fraudulent? Yung exaggerations ba daw? Pwede ba yun? Masasabi ba natin yun ng fraudulent? Yung ika nga ay nagkakaroon tayo ng pagyayabang minsan. So, sa Tagalog kasi ang pagyayabang here is parang nagsisingol. Pero yung yabang na ini-exaggerate natin, pinapasobrahan, kumbaga. So, well, basically, ha, ang tatanda natin, in a contract of sale, the buyer should always be on guard. When you have the duty to check for, let's say, for lupa, when you have the duty to check for the title of the seller, ano, otherwise, well, the buyer buys the thing at your own risk. So, we call that one, yun yung caveat doon. Let the buyer beware. So, for you, you should examine, when you have the opportunity to know for the facts, well, they are not considered as fraudulent na act. Yun ay mga dealer stock lang. Ano? So, dapat ay hindi natin siya i-consider na fraudulent na act which would subject to damages or cancellation ng contract. Ano pa ba? 1342, which is misrepresentation. Under 1342, misrepresentation by a third person does not vitiate consent unless such mistake such misrepresentation has created a substantial mistake and the same is mutual. So, ibig sabihin nito, under 1342, yung, as a general rule, kapag po yung misrepresentation ay caused by a third person, hindi siya nagko-constitute ng error that would make the contract voidable. Yun yung general rule. Not unless yung mistake ay mutual o di kaya yung misrepresentation has created ng substantial mistake. Ano ba example nito? Pagpapalagay, I entered into a contract with you. Ano? Tapos, yung pagpapalagay, ako at si Coco Martin ay nag-enter into a contract with you. Tapos, ang consent ni Coco ay na-obtain lang because niloko ko si Coco, ano, dinideceive ko or dinidefraud ko si Coco. Ngayon, eto bang si Coco Martin can ask for the annulment of the contract with you? Well, in that case, no. Kasi basically, ha, ang tatandaan natin dito, ikaw, hindi ka naman party to the fraud being committed by me, diba? Hindi ka party to the fraud. Ang aking niloko lang din to enter into a contract with you is si Coco Martin. Suppose, meron pong third person, pagpapalagay natin ay si S, na kung saan, ini-intimidate nila kami ni Coco at ako to enter into a contract with you. Kumbaga tinatakot, ano? Can the contract in that case be annulled? Well, on this example, under 1336 po pwede, diba? Pero natatandaan nyo sa 1336 na mention ko na kapag violence or intimidation, it would annul the obligation although it may have been employed by a third person who did not take part in the contract. So, hope by this you could differentiate against 1336 na kung saan violence or intimidation by third person ay nakaka-annul ng contract unlike 1342 na misrepresentation by a third person, hindi po siya nakaka-annul ng contract. What if nagkakaroon ka ng misrepresentation tapos hindi mo naman sinasadya? Yun yung sinasabi nating misrepresentation in good faith. Anong mangyayari? Let's say, for example, I sold my ring to you. Ano? Well, I have misrepresented it as a diamond ring. Kaso, it turns out na it is fake naman. Could that contract be annulled on the ground of mistake? Well, yes, pero hindi siya pwedeng ipa-annul because of fraud. Bakit? Kasi misrepresentation naman yun in good faith. So, ang classification pala, kapag hindi, kapag ang misrepresentation is done in good faith, then ang grounds po natin ay mistake, hindi po fraud. Ano? And then, 1334. Ano bang 1334? Aray, 1343. Made in good faith. 1345 and 46. Well, 1344, simulation of contracts. 1345 is simulation of contracts, and 1344 it states that in order that fraud may make a contract voidable, it should be serious and should not have been employed by both contracting parties. So yun yung sinasabi natin kanina, requirements as to that in order that a contract would fraud that would make a contract voidable. Let's have 1345. Under 1345, it talks about simulation of contracts, which is could be daw relative or absolute ang simulation. Kailan ba absolute and then kailan ba relative? So, kapag po absolute, ang nangyayari ay kapag po absolute, it takes place where the parties do not intend to be bound at all. An absolutely simulated or fictitious na contract ay void. Kapag po relative naman, takes place when the parties conceal their true agreement. A relatively simulated contract when it does not prejudice a third person is not intended for any purpose contrary to law, morals, good customs, public order, public policy, binds the parties to their real agreement. Well, we'll go back. Ano ba yung simulation ng contract? Ang simulation ng contract, ito yung declaration of a fictitious will deliberately made by agreement of the parties in order to promote for the purpose of deception the appearance of a juridical act which do not exist, with the purpose of deceiving others, and the appearance of a transaction which do not exist or which is different from the true agreement. So different from which was really being executed. Ano? So kapag absolute nga, parties do not intend to be bound, void from the very beginning. Ano yung example nito? Ang example ng absolute ay yung marriage contracted by jest. Ano ba yung marriage by jest? Ang marriage by jest, ito yung ito yung kapag po nagpapakasal ang dalawa na wala naman talagang silang intensyon na magiging mag-asawa, like for purposes lang ng citizenship, yung mag-asawa ka lang ng kano para ikaw ay magkaroon ng hindi ka palalayasin sa mag-asawa ka ng foreigner sa isang bansa para lang ikaw ay hindi po paalisin. So, yun yung example or pa-deport, ano? Yun yung example ng marriage pages, which from the very beginning ay the parties have no intention to be bound at all. Kapag naman relative, eto, they conceal the true agreement, tatandaan nito, pero hindi naman sila po nakaka-endure ng third person. Hindi nga lang nila pinapakita yung true nila na agreement. Ano, valid naman siya provided na hindi po siya intended for any purpose contrary to law, morals, good customs, and public order. Ito yung mga karaniwan natin nakakasalubong minsan. When we sell for when we sell property and then we would experience na medyo napakamahal na mga transfer taxes, ang gagawin natin ay instead of contract of sale, ang gagawin natin ay nakikiusap tayo na donation na lang kasi mas mababa yung donor's tax na babayaran. So, basically, that is a relative na simulation ng contract. Let's now go for objects of contracts.